world famous Chicky Jaguar radio broadcast. See the book, hear the movie. Or no, it's see the movie, read the book. But I wanted to say, read the movie, see the book. That's what I wanted to say. Hear the book, see the movie. We are going to go to Frank Vernuccio. Yes, that Vernuccio. And we are going to see if he is there. If he is there, as they say. And I believe there's Vernuccio. How are you, my friend? It's Jigmund Freud giving you a call for your segment. How are you, sir?
Jim, it's great to be with you again.
Now, there is a lot going on. It's like there's a presidential election.
When was the last time that there was such a thing as a slow news week? If you remember, years ago, there was a time, believe it or not, all our younger listeners,
yes,
that news reporters and news programs used to worry about the last couple of weeks of August. They used to say it was a slow news week and you had to scramble to find something that made a lot of sense to put on the air in a news broadcast. Oh, for the good old days.
I used to remember picking up the local newspaper, and they would have some weird story on there. And my grandmother used to say, slow news day.
Yeah.
but there seems to be just all sorts of things happening. There's Democrats as Republicans. Oh, my. But I want to get your thoughts on this thing that happened, I don't know, about a week or two ago in, as Tom Likas likes to say, Portland, home of the other white meat. Portland rioters are burning Bibles, and Representative Clyburn says it's their business. When asked about the rioters in Portland burning Bibles, Democrat Rep. James Clyburn responds, "That's their business." What do you think of this, Frank?
I guess it was also their business when they decided to try to burn down a federal courthouse.
Yes.
Look, the attack on the courthouse is important because it illustrates what the mindset of these folks actually are, the Antifas and the BLMs. In my mind, and I think many historians are looking at the attack on the federal courthouse in almost the same manner that they looked upon the attack on Fort Sumter back in 1861 to start the Civil War. When you attack a federal courthouse, it's not a statement of protest, it's not a riot, it's an act of rebellion against the lawful authority of the Constitution and the federal government.
Yes.
To make matters worse, James, because Portland has had such a dismally poor record of trying to restore order in their ravaged city, the federal government, Department of Homeland Security, sent its people there to try to protect that federal courthouse. You had prominent politicians, including Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi, calling the Department of Homeland Security agents, quote, stormtroopers, and she likened them to the Nazi Gestapo. So you're not only
fantastic
saying it's okay to protest, okay to burn down a federal courthouse, you're seeing any lawful exercise of federal authority as being likened to a stormtrooper. Now, this is part of a process of trying to delegitimize the federal government, a process that began back in 2016 when people like the ex-CIA chief John Brennan, former FBI chief Jim Comey, and the former head of the National Security Agency, James Clapper, came together to try to overturn the results of the election by leveling false charges of Russian collusion. What you're seeing in places like Portland is actually the end result of that. When you're talking about burning Bibles, for heaven's sakes, that's an act of rebellion not only against the Constitution, but an act of rebellion against Western civilization itself.
Yes.
If you look at what the protesters are doing and saying, when they're saying, for example, that they want to reject the concept of private property, when they don't believe in basically the Bill of Rights, you're rejecting not just the American Constitution, but everything that's gone on in Western civilization for the past 300 or 400 years, probably longer.
Definitely.
That's what's so important about the burning of the Bible.
We have got Frank Vernuccio with us today. He joins us live here in a broadcast. So Frank, with some of the different things going on, what do you make of these online conventions they're going to be doing? The Democrats, I believe, is next week, or the Republicans will be either a week after or so.
Well, we're all at the edge of our seats, just waiting to see who Joe Biden actually picks as his vice president. Some suspect that he actually picked somebody for his vice president, but if you got who it was.
That's awesome.
It's going to be very important who he chooses as vice president. It's going to tell a lot about his administration in several different ways. Number one, because of the former vice president's ill health. It's very likely that before the end of his first term, that vice presidential pick will become the actual president of the United States if, in fact, Biden wins the election.
Yeah.
Which is why it's so distressing at this point in the pre-convention time that the people that appear to be on Biden's short list are not necessarily people who I think the American public have a lot of confidence in because they're being picked more for their gender and their color rather than for any history of accomplishment. We're looking at someone like Karen Bass, for heaven's sakes, an admirer of Fidel Castro. That really inspires confidence. We're looking at the senator from California, who basically got her start by sleeping her way to the high ranks of the Democratic Party, and a variety of other officials who are notable for their hard left policies. There's no compromise there. There's no middle of the road. They are simply hard leftists who probably would not win a general election and don't seem to have the qualifications to actually serve as president of the United States. It's a tense time.
It is. Frank Vernuccio, he joins us today here on the big broadcast. And so what do you have coming up on the radio program this weekend, my friend?
Well, we're going to be talking to two interesting, very, very interesting people. We've got Shannon Gobadi. Now, who you ask is Shannon Gobadi. He is one of the people leading the Iranian underground movement, an attempt to overthrow the mullahs and restore some form of freedom to the Iranian people. That promises to be a really fascinating and one-of-a-kind interview. We're also going to be talking to Cordy Williams, who is a constitutional advocate, a former Marine, and he's talking about the mass release of prisoners from jail. One of the points he's making is that if people had so much confidence in those masks, rather than releasing killers and rapists from jail, why not just issue them really good masks and let them stay in place where they are in jail? So we're looking forward to two really interesting interviews.
Fantastic. Well, I appreciate it, Frank. And before we let you go, how do people find you online, sir?
Thanks for asking, James. USAGovPolicy.com.
Good stuff. I will talk to you next week. Thank you, Frank.
Looking forward to it, James. Thanks.
Appreciate it, brother. There he goes, Frank Vernuccio, USA Gov Policy. And we got more coming back. G.E. Smith and the Saturday Night Live Band. I don't know what that even means. Remember G.E. Smith?
Jiggy Jaguar.
Neil Bortz with us today.
If they put Fox News on, liberals will complain.
Uh-huh.
If they put CNN on, conservatives are going to complain.
Jiggy Jaguar.
We've got Tom Donahue with us today. I started to organize, not like Obama.
Jiggy Jaguar.
Publisher of Talkers Magazine, Michael Harrison.
And it's a lot of fun, and it's very informative, and it does a lot of things. One, it's
www.jiggyjaguar.com.
KJagRadio.com. 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 JiggyJagRadio.com. You got the power, I got the need. KJagRadio.com.
It's a new year here at the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Show, and we are ramping up for a tremendous, tremendous 2014. We have a lot of things coming up this year. We're doing a lot of television projects, going to be doing a lot of radio as well, and we need your help. Shop our Amazon.com links. You can do all of your shopping through our website at JiggyJaguar.com. That's JiggyJaguar.com. It's as simple as clicking on our Amazon link. That will take you to Amazon. Amazon will still look the same. It'll still feel the same. You'll still get the same deals. We just get a little bit of help off a commission from Amazon if you do shopping through our link. Also, we have our advertising available on Fiverr.com, as well as many of these other micro sites around the internet. We have a complete list at our website, JiggyJaguar.com. Recently, we had Dr. Ted Baer on the program talking advertising with us.
If they said that our media doesn't have any influence, why would somebody buy an ad? Why would somebody buy an ad on your program? Hey, we don't have any impact. There's no reason for you to... So it's a no-brainer.
It truly is a no-brainer, as they say. Okay, we are going to go to Dr. Dean Hart. Yes, that Dr. Dean Hart. And we are going to get him in the saddle, as they say. I don't know who's saying it. Don't know why they're saying it, but they are indeed saying it.